Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy. In this lecture, we will discuss about field effect transistor, which is commonly known as FET. FET is used to amplify the weak signal, which means the application of field effect transistor is similar to the application of bipolar junction transistor. But there are few differences between BJT and FET. BJT is bipolar junction transistor, FET is field effect transistor. The first major difference is BJT is current control device and FET is a voltage control device. If we consider a BJT here, we know BJTs consist of three terminals, emitter, base and collector. In BJT, base current is used to control collector current as well as emitter current. That's why we can call this as control current. In FET, there are three terminals, source, drain and gate. Here the source current IS and drain current ID is controlled by using a voltage between gate and source, which we specify it as VGS. This voltage is used to control the current flowing through the FET. That's why we can call this as control voltage. So from this we can identify in BJT, base current is used to control the current flowing through the device, and in FET, the gate to source voltage is used to control the flow of current inside the device. BJT can be classified as NPN and PNP transistor, whereas FET can be classified as N channel and P channel transistors. BJT is a bipolar device. The conduction is the function of two charges, holes and electrons. But FET is unipolar device, because the conduction depends upon either electrons or holes. So as you can see from the classification of FET, we have N channel and P channel. In N channel FET, the conduction depends upon only electrons, and in P channel FET, the conduction depends upon only holes. That's why we can call this as unipolar device. FET is having high input impedance and they are more stable to the temperature than BJT. If we compare BJT and FET, the FET is more stable to the temperature than the BJT. And FET are usually very small compared to BJT, making them practically useful in ICs, integrated circuit. Now we'll see the types of FET. We can classify FET into two types. Broadly, we can classify it into two types. The first type is junction field effect transistor, and the second type is MOSFET, which is metal oxide field effect transistor. JFET can be classified again into two types. Again, we can classify JFET into two types: N-channel JFET and P-channel JFET. MOSFET can be classified into two types, depletion type and enhancement type. Again, these depletion type can be classified as N-channel and P-channel depletion type of MOSFET, And enhancement type again can be classified as N channel and P channel, enhancement type of MOSFET. Now we'll see the construction of FET. FET can be classified as N channel FET and a P channel FET. This figure shows the structure of N channel FET. It consists of two P type semiconducting material which is heavily doped. The region between P type is known as a channel. Since the channel is N type, it is known as N channel FET. The channel provides the path for electrons to flow. It will provide the path for electrons to flow. It consists of three terminals and we will call this as electrodes. These electrodes are known as ohmic contacts. The upper side of the channel is a drain terminal and the lower side of the channel is the source. And the electrodes which are connected to P side is known as gate terminal. There will be a depletion region which will be formed between the N type and P type material. The electrons will enter the channel through source and leave the channel through drain terminal. Gate terminal is used to control the flow of electrons. Now we will write the symbol of FET. The symbol is like this. It will be having three terminals and the arrow mark here is inside and the terminal is gate. Here it is drain and it is source. This is the structure of P channel FET. Here the construction is same. The only difference is we are having two N type semiconducting material which is connected to gate and the channel is made up of the P type semiconducting material. Now we will write the symbol for this. Symbol looks very similar to the N channel FET. The difference is the arrow mark is towards outside in the gate terminal. This is drain and source. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.